After the squabbles of the campaign, it could all come down to playground politics.
If David Cameron or Ed Miliband can't get more than half the MPs, then they'll need some help to form a government.
Labour have promised not to form a coalition or to do a deal with the SNP, but they might still need their help.
Even though they disagree on some big issues, like renewing the Trident nuclear weapon.
Whatever happens, the SNP wouldn't back the Tories over there. But UKIP might stand by them if they promise a referendum on the EU this year.
Then it could come down to who makes friends with the Liberal Democrats who want more spending in 3 years' time.
They might join Labour in government taking jobs as ministers, although they've ruled out any arrangement with the SNP. Or they could choose the Conservatives, like they did at the last election. Or perhaps Labour or the Tories could try to get by on their own, fighting vote by vote in a minority government. Either way, smaller parties could be crucial, like the SDLP from Northern Ireland, Welsh Nationalist Plaid Cymru, and the Greens, who might back Labour. Also from Northern Ireland, the Alliance and the Democratic Unionists, who could support either side.
The winner will be whoever can command the confidence of the House of Commons.
No!
But grown-ups like children can fall out, and it could all end in a big, noisy mess.